You want a grip that makes possible the whole range of strokes. Here it is. You actually hold the blade of the bat between the forefinger and thumb. This adds firmness and control and makes the bat an extension of your hand, as it were. Clasp the remaining fingers round the handle without straining. You're going to use one side of your bat for all four hand strokes, the side where your thumb is, and the reverse side, the finger side, for all backhand strokes. In the forehand, the thumb stays naturally at the bottom of the blade, but when you're playing backhand, the thumb acts as a control and moves up, like this, to a more or less vertical position. Good. Now that's taken care of the bat. But wait a minute. How are you standing? This is the standard stance. Knees a little bent and weight slightly forward. From this position, you can get quickly to the right or left to play forehand or backhand strokes. And you can move backwards or forwards. There are some fundamental things about bat motion, too. The simplest possible stroke is just a pushing motion of the bat. You swing about half arm's length, straight, slowly, and almost horizontal. However, it's practically impossible to hit a light ball through the air and stop it turning on its axis. You have to use spin. Table tennis is a game of spin. Here's top spin. You brush the bat up or over the ball. The rubber pimples on the modern bat enable it to get a momentary grip on the ball and to impart a spin to it. Top spin causes the ball to dip sharply in flight after the initial rise. When it lands, the ball kicks off fast and tends to crawl up off the receiver's bat. The way to counter top spin is for the receiver to face his bat downward. Underspin, or chop, is produced by brushing the bat down or under the ball. It then soars in flight before dropping steeply. How does an underspun ball land? Like this. It grips the table and hangs back on bouncing. When it's received, it tries to run down off the receiver's bat, and the player should counter it by sloping the surface of his bat backward. These spins should be mastered thoroughly by continual practice, for spin is the basis of table tennis technique. Now we'll study the actual play. There are 10 fundamental shots. Watch them. There's the forehand service. The backhand service. Then the forehand drive and its complement, the backhand drive. This is the half volley. And here's the flick. The smash. The forehand chop, the backhand chop, and finally the drop shot. Cantlay and Algy will demonstrate these 10 basic strokes. We'll take the service first. To prevent the use of hand or finger spin, you must hold the ball like this. It must be thrown up from the open palm and is usually struck about net height. You can use top or underspin in your service. The backhand service. Now let's consider the forehand drive, the basic attacking shot. You start the stroke about table height and hit the ball with strong topspin. The topspin is combined with forward speed. Put your weight behind each stroke. Make a long swing with the arm fully extended, and most important, follow right through to about head height. The backhand drive, another attacking shot. The weight should pass onto the forward foot as the ball is struck. You start the shot near your left hip. Hit the ball at the top of its bounce, or a little before, and swing the arm to three-quarter length, upward and forward. you finish the follow-through about the height of your head. Now we'll look at the half volley. This is the foundation stroke of table tennis. It's the first shot that should be learnt because all the other strokes are built on it. You usually stand square on or half sideways. You can play a forehand or backhand half volley. There is almost no swing. Place the bat within an inch or two of the bounce. The clicks on the table and bat are practically simultaneous. Our sixth fundamental shot is the flick. This is an attacking shot made by the backhand. You make it mostly with the forearm. It looks as if it's played principally with the wrist, but if you watch closely, you'll see that the wrist comes into play only in the last fraction of a second in order to give direction. Victor Barnard is the master of this shot, and he says, "The flick is simply a backhand drive steered by the action of the wrist." Shot 7 is the smash. This is a point-winning stroke against a high ball. You draw the bat well back, and a straight swing is aimed so that the bat tends to pass through the ball, as it were. A slight topspin makes the smash surer, but you must smash with confidence, without hesitation. Smash it! Next, the chop shots, forehand and backhand. These are the main defensive strokes. Here's the forehand chop. The swing is at 3/4 arm's length, downward to give underspin, and forward just enough to control the bounce. You strike the ball as it's dropping from the highest point of its bounce. Bend both knees and transfer your weight to the forward foot as you hit. You should finish the shot with your arm extended down and forward. Now, what about the backhand chop? Turn well sideways, just as you did in the backhand drive. The bat swing is 3/4 arm's length, downward, and starts about the height of your head. You have your arm well back on the line with the ball's flight, and your elbow is bent. The ball is hit as it's dropping, and you finish with the arm extended downward and forward. The tenth fundamental stroke is the drop shot. Although not an attacking stroke, it's inseparable from attack. When your opponent, the defender, is playing back from the table, you drop the ball over the net out of his reach. It's desirable to use a half volley, either forehand or backhand, and the shot's more effective if a pretense hit is made. Now we'll watch some of these shots used in match play by two of the world's most famous players, Victor Barnard and Richard Bergman. Table tennis today is a scientific game. To play it well, you must have a thorough mastery of its fundamental strokes.